This video is part 2 of a 2-part series where we will be creating an activity or node network diagram, and I'll be using the same example that was used in part 1 video where we developed the activity on arrow network diagram. So in part 1 we did the background of the activity on arrow, we created an activity on arrow network diagram, and then we did the forward and backward path. Now in this video, we will create the activity on node network diagram using the same example as part 1, and we'll also be doing the forward path and backward path. Now the activity will be presented by a rectangle with the activity name in the middle, the duration of the activity right above it, and then we'll have the early start and early finish. We'll also calculate the late start and late finish, and then the float as well. Now the float is calculated by the late finish minus the early finish, that's our float. And when we do the forward pass, the highest early finish will go to the next node, and when we do the backward path, the lowest late start will go to the next node. So let's do the example. If we create the network diagram, we can see in our example that activity A, B, and C is connected to start. So we've got activity A, B, and C that's connected to start. Activity A is connected to D. Activity A is connected to E. Activity B is connected to E. So activity B is connected to E. Then we've got activity C and E connected to F, activity C and E connected to F, activity D and E connected to G, activity D and E connected to G, and then activity G and F connected to the finish node to end, G and F connected to the end. The duration of the activities, activity start is 0. Activity A is 1, activity B is 3 days, activity C is 5 days, activity D is 6 days, activity E is 7 days, activity F is 3 days, and activity G is 5 days, and the end is 0. And when we do our forward pass, we start with our early start, which is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. Then A starts at 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. B starts at 0, 0 plus 3 is 3. And C starts at 0, that's our early start, 0 plus 5 is 5. We go to activity D. Activity D starts at 1, 1 plus 6 is 7. Activity E starts at 3, 3 plus 7 is 10. Then if we go to activity F, we've got 10 and 5. When we do the forward pass, we use the highest early finish, which is 10. 10 plus 3 is 13. The same with G, we've got 7 and 10. We use the highest early finish, which is 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. And then if we move to the end, we've got 15 and 13. We use the highest, that is 15. 15 plus 0 is 15. And that is our project duration is 15 days, which is also the same as was calculated in part 1 when we did the activity on arrow method. We've got 15, 15 minus 15 is 0, so it's a 0 float. 15 minus 0 duration is 15. Then the late finish for G is 15. 15 minus 15 is 0, that's our float. And 15 minus 5 is 10. That's our late start for activity G. We've got our late finish of 15. 15 minus 13 is 2. That's our float. And 15 minus 3 is 12. For D, we've got our late finish of 10 days. 10 minus 7 is 3. That's our float. And 10 minus 6 is 4. Then for E, we've got 10 and 12. If we do the backward pass, we use the lowest late start, which is 10. 10 minus 10 is 0, that's our float. 10 minus 7 is 3, that's our late start for activity E. Then we've got 12, our late finish. 12 minus 5 is 7, that's our float. 12 minus 5 is 7, that's our late start. For activity B, the late finish is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0, that's our late start for activity B. And for A, our late finish is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3, that's our float. And 4 minus 1 is 3, that's our late start. And then our late finish for the start is 3 or 0 or 7. If we do the backward path, it's our lowest late start, which is 0. So it's 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, it's our float, and 0 minus 0 is 0. So our project duration is 15 days. Our critical path is where the float is 0. So that's our start, activity B, E, G, and F, which is also the same that was calculated in part 1 when we did the activity on arrow method. I hope this video helped you to understand the activity on node method, and I will also add the links to some of my other activity on node videos, including the activity on node video where we added the leads and lags to the activities. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, and if you are interested in future videos, you're welcome to subscribe.